This video tutorial is intended for graduate students using Montezuma Publishing formatting templates. All SGSU master's theses need to follow some simple universal formatting guidelines. There are 13 rules that you will need to adhere to when formatting your document. Visit our website at montezumapublishing.com for the full list and details. Nearly all students find it easiest to meet the universal formatting requirements by using the appropriate template for their discipline. We have designed the templates to assist you with the formatting requirements. The template contains all of the correct formatting for preliminary pages, a page to auto-generate the table of contents and lists of tables or figures, and all of the necessary styles for headings, text, images, and references. This video will show you how to apply Microsoft Word template styles to your document to meet the university guidelines. Before you begin, you will need to download the thesis template or dissertation template found on our website at montezumapublishing.com. The template and these instructions are designed for Microsoft Word. This tutorial is conducted using Windows 10 and Microsoft Word for Microsoft 365 version 2301. Different versions of the operating system or MS Word may look different, but you should still be able to complete these steps. If you are writing your thesis without the template and now want to switch, you do not need to start over from the beginning. Follow the instructions for performing a subdocument import to safely copy your existing documents into the template. Instructions can be found on our website, or you can view our tutorial for this procedure by clicking the link in this video. With the template open, we'll begin by turning on our paragraph marks by clicking on the Home tab, then clicking on the paragraph marker in the ribbon. Then, open the Styles window by clicking on the arrow in the bottom right corner of the Styles ribbon. There are two different views you can use. You can use the regular list view, or you can click the Show Preview option to view what the style will look like in text. The Show Preview option lets you view fewer styles at a time, but it can make it easier to find the style you are looking for if you're not familiar with all of the style names. Remember, the template contains instructions and examples of various types of formatting that you can reference to see which style should be applied to what type of content. So if you're not sure what a style is called or which style you should use, look at an unused copy of the template with the Styles panel open, and then apply the same styles to your document. The styles we will be covering in this video are title pages, titles 1 line through 4 lines, chapter labels, chapter titles, and section titles, normal paragraph text using normal and normal plus first line indent, heading levels 1 through 3, block quotations, numbered and bullet lists, table titles, single space text, figures and figure captions, equations, and references. Now that we have the styles open and we're familiar with all of the style names, we can begin formatting. Place your cursor anywhere within the paragraph that you want to format, and then select the appropriate style from the Styles panel. This will apply the style to the entire paragraph. You do not need to select the text directly to apply a style. It's really simple. When we do this to the entire document, most of the formatting requirements will be met automatically. I should note that you need to be sure to apply the styles even if it looks like it's already applied. Sometimes a section of text will look like it's in the style you want when it really isn't. This can cause layout errors or prevent you from successfully using the template's automatic table of contents generator, so be thorough in your application. Okay, let's start at the beginning of your document with the title. The length of the title will determine which style we will use. You can see there are 4 options, title 1 line through 4 lines. If your title fits on 1 line, apply the title 1 line style. If your title is 2, 3, or 4 lines long, then apply the title 2, 3, or 4 line style. Using the correct style will adjust the spacing above the title so that all of the title page contents fit correctly on the page. Next, we'll look at chapter labels, chapter titles, and section titles. Depending on your program's requirements, You must format the major divisions of your text as either chapters or sections. You can find out what your program requires by downloading the department guidelines from our website. The three possible text formats are chapter, section, or technical. Applying these styles will satisfy Rule 5 of the Universal Guidelines by starting each chapter or section on a new page and increasing the top margin on that page to 2 inches. Applying the correct style and text will allow you to use our template's automatic table of contents generator. If you must use chapter or technical format, you will use the chapter label and chapter title styles. The chapter label style is applied to the chapter number, and the chapter title style is applied to the name of the chapter. So you can see where it says Chapter 1, we have applied Chapter Label, and where it says Introduction, we have applied the chapter title. If your department requires you to use section format, then apply the section title style for major divisions in your thesis. You can see here that we have applied the section title style to the Introduction. SDSU paragraphs are indented at a half inch and use 12-point font with 1.5 line spacing. We have two paragraph styles, normal with no indent, and normal plus first line indent with the half inch indent included. Apply the appropriate normal style to each paragraph in your document. Heading level styles 1 through 5 are included in the template. Here is an example of a heading 1. Here is an example of a heading 2. Here is an example of a heading 3. These styles do not capitalize major words for you. Applying the correct style in text will automatically apply the appropriate amount of offset spacing before and after the heading, and headings 1 through 3 will auto-generate on the table of contents. The template includes styles for block quotations and numbered or bullet lists. Block quotations and lists are to be single line spaced according to Rule 4 in the Universal Formatting Requirements. Applying the correct style in text will automatically apply the appropriate indents and the offset spacing before and after each item. The template also has styles for tables and figures. For tables, you should use the table title and table note styles. According to Rule 4 in the Universal Formatting Requirements, tables are to be single line spaced. Apply the single spaced text style to your contents of your table to ensure that the correct line spacing is being used. For figures, you should use the caption and figure styles. Applying the figure style to your image will center the item on the page and make the figure keep with next, which will ensure that the image and corresponding caption appear on the same page. Apply the caption style to your figure description and adjust the alignment as needed. Applying the table title and caption styles in text will allow you to use the auto-generate features in the preliminary pages for your list of tables and list of figures. For equations, we recommend using the equation style so that your equation is centered on the page and the parenthetical equation reference number is right aligned. Apply the equation style and then add a tab marker before the equation and between the equation and the parenthetical number. There are two styles that can be used to format your references. There is hanging indent and hanging indent author number. Both styles apply the appropriate line spacing and indent levels to your reference entries. Hanging indent should be used for reference styles like APA, MLA, and Chicago. Hanging indent author number is for number styles like IEEE, LaTeX, or Chicago author number. For numbered styles, place your reference number in brackets and add two tab markers for a single digit number and one tab marker for a double digit number. The template contains a few additional styles not reviewed in this video, but now that you're familiar with how to apply styles, you should be able to navigate the rest of your formatting with ease. While Montezuma Publishing is unable to teach each individual student how to format their document, we do try to provide tools and guides to make meeting the requirements easier. For additional resources, video tutorials, and more information, please visit our YouTube channel or our website at montezumapublishing.com or contact a graduate publishing associate by email at thesis@aztecmail.com. Happy formatting!